God and the protection and the provision, where is our altar? Where is our consecration? Amen?
Amen.
Yes. Where is our sacrifice?
Yes.
The Old Testament is littered with blood sacrifices. Even right here, we just described one. God told him explicitly, get the bull that is 7 years old. And God told him how to prepare it. Okay? He sacrificed the bull.
Yes.
Prior to that, he had prepared some food.
My Lord.
And the Lord accepted that. The angel accepted that sacrifice.
Yes.
Two sacrifices that same night.
Yes.
Sacrifices get us closer to God.
Yes.
And this is where we are, and this is why we ask the question, why has all these things happened to us if the Lord is with us?
Yes.
We are called by the name, but we worship the name.
Mm-hmm.
I'll backtrack 1 second.
Mm-hmm.
Everything we do is for a purpose.
Yes.
In worship, we raise our hands out of surrender.
Mm-hmm. Amen.
People see you raise your hand, they were never taught how, why, and what we do during worship. The modern day church says we worship with our hearts. I'll give you an example. The words of the song say, on bended knees I come.
Yes.
No one kneels.
My Lord.
Because we say we do it spiritually.
My God. So true.
Partial obedience is disobedience to God.
Yes, yes.
You can never say to God something and lie to God and expect Him to manifest in your life.
My Lord.
God knows your intention. Your intention may be to worship Him. Yes.
Right.
But don't say things that you can't or you don't intend. We often say things and say it as if God understands.
My Lord.
God understands. I'm only going to shack up because this is my provision. This is how I pay my bills.
My Lord.
God understands. He knows my heart.
My
He knows.
My God.
And then we ask, why have all these things happened to us?
My Lord.
Amen?
Amen.
Worship is one of those things we can never take lightly. Worship is the most important thing to God. Worship, your act of worship. Let's go to the book of Romans, chapter 12.